Labor is claiming an economic victory over your cost of living crisis, but in reality, their shoddy economic management has been exposed, and that's why your interest rates are staying high. Instead of doing the hard yards and trimming spending and lowering the cost of electricity, like they promised they would, Anthony Albanese and Jim Chalmers used billions of dollars of your money to try to trick the Reserve Bank, and it failed. Failed as it always was going to do. Let me explain. The official inflation figure came out today and, superficially, it was good news. It dropped below 3% to 2.7%, right where the Reserve Bank wants it to go so that we can get some interest rate relief. And the Treasurer, who is always smug and self-satisfied, no matter how tough the cost of living crisis gets, well, today he was again applauding his own work.
These are very welcome, very encouraging and very heartening numbers.
The trouble is, they're actually not. A large part of the fall happened because power prices had been artificially and temporarily pushed downwards by federal and state government subsidies. So the underlying inflation rate, the trimmed mean or the real inflation rate, if you like, did not drop as low. That rate is still at 3.4%. which is higher than the RBA needs it to be to lower rates. It needs inflation to be between 2 and 3%. Now, this is very important to understand because it explains why rates are remaining high and it demonstrates how Chalmers and Albanese have been busy spending your money on what they hoped would be a tricky political fix, artificially suppressing power prices with taxpayers' money, instead of doing what they promised to do, that is deliver an efficient electricity grid providing cheaper power. To those not singing Labor's tune, this was obvious back in May on Budget Day when it was first announced. It doesn't do anything to stop costs going higher. It doesn't actually fix the underlying problem. And the following day, we went into more detail about what Labor was trying to do. The big trick of this budget, the attempted con, is a huge gamble. Labor is hoping that the $300 per household power rebate, money paid directly to your electricity provider to keep your bill lower, will trigger an artificial reduction in inflation, push inflation down with taxpayers' money. And they think that that might trick the Reserve Bank into lowering rates. Now, surely this is unlikely because the bank knows that this doesn't do anything about the underlying cause of high electricity prices, and it knows that when the rebate cuts out, then that cost is going to go straight back onto consumers. Now, it's nice to show you that that analysis turns out to be right, but the crucial point is that this exposes just how cynical and lazy Labor have been. We could see it all along. Because this is exactly how it's come to pass. Albanese and Chalmers might have conned some voters and they might have conned their barrackers in the Canberra Press Gallery, but they didn't con the Reserve Bank. In fact, the Governor warned about this and predicted it yesterday. In her statement, Michelle Bullock predicted a fall in headline inflation and importantly, she called it temporary because of these cost of living measures. But she still didn't see inflation sustainably returning to the target rate until 2026. And she then reinforced this point in her media conference.
One thing that we are expecting with tomorrow's monthly CPI is that we will expect to see the cost of living relief come into play. And that what that's going to do is that's going to lower energy prices. If tomorrow we get an inflation number which has got a 2 in front of it, so it's back in the band, that doesn't mean that we've got inflation under control. It doesn't mean that inflation is sustainably back within the band. It just means it's back there at the moment.
Yeah, and the Governor still says underlying inflation, real inflation, looks like staying too high for more than a year yet. In fact, look out for inflation spiking again, of course, when Labor's lazy subsidies run out. So let's recap Labor's performance on inflation and interest rates. First, they promised the world.
Labor has real lasting plans for cheaper electricity, cheaper childcare, cheaper mortgages.
And instead, rates went up a dozen times and they've stayed up. And when Labor failed to control spending and failed to push power prices down and failed to ease the cost of living, it started bashing the Reserve Bank. The Treasurer said monetary policy was smashing the economy, and his old boss and mentor, Wayne Swan, the ALP National President, went even further.
The drivers of inflation in this country are not going to be affected and not going to come down by hammering mums and dads with higher rates. The Reserve Bank is simply punching itself in the face. It's counterproductive. And it's not good economic policy, and I'm incredibly disappointed with what they're doing.
And now, after all that Reserve Bank bashing, we've seen how Labor's effort to trick the bank using $3.5 billion of your money, well, it didn't do it. It's fallen flat. It fooled no one. The bank saw through it, and you and I are stuck with higher interest rates for the foreseeable future and power prices that will jump up again when Labor's attempted con runs out. But wait, there's more. Now Labor is coming for real estate investments too. Remember when Bill Shorten led Labor at the 2019 election, he promised to pull back on negative gearing and capital gains tax concessions. It was dumb policy. It would exacerbate our housing crisis rather than fix it. But anyway, that meant that at the last election, Labor promised to leave all this alone.
We will provide that certainty and stability when it comes to the existing negative gearing and capital gains tax regimes.
But now we're told that Treasury are working up plans to cut back on negative gearing and/or change capital gains tax rules. And the Prime Minister does not rule it out.
Treasury, I'm sure, like other departments, do a range of proposals, policy, ideas. I want a public service that is full of ideas.
If Labor does anything in this space, it'll be one more broken promise to add to the list. And it won't ease the housing crisis. It'll only make it worse.